Do you know what's the best way to shock anyone? Ask them, who are you? 2 semesters ago, I was leading a workshop in one of my classes when I had to ask my colleagues this very question. Their faces went blank. They were at a loss of words, and it felt like I had uncovered everyone's best kept secret. So, when someone asks you, who are you? How does it feel? What's the first answer that crosses your mind? Is it your name? Your major? Maybe your business or profession? Could it be your political leader? Aren't you tired of all these cliche quotes we read every day on social media? Know yourself, find who you are, be your success, get rich or die trying. Yourself is waiting for you. These quotes are misleading, and finding who you are doesn't happen overnight. Let me tell you a story. September 11, 2001. I was 19 years old. 4 in the afternoon, I was at my parents' house watching TV. Flipping through channels, and on comes the news. A terrorist attack on the Twin Towers of New York City. In a day that changed the course of life for many countries and many people, I was smashed to the core and left with doubts. I questioned my identity, my purpose in life, and my values. And then I asked myself, what do I stand for? What do I stand for? This was one of the times when I consciously questioned my values. But what is a value? A definition I like by Stuart Friedman, author of Total Leadership, says, it is what you hold most dear and willing to strive and fight for. It determines your actions and how you view the world around you. I don't know about you, but I thought that values are limited to flowery, abstract words. Words like love and peace and respect. It turned out that many far more tangible concepts, concepts that exist in our daily lives, are defined as values. Things like family, education, competition, challenge, authority, duty, a crazy list you'd never expect. What we don't realize is that such values influence our life priorities. And in turn, our priorities shape our daily life decisions. Decisions like what job to apply for, how we spend our money, how we treat our parents, whether to give back to community or keep it all to ourselves, whether to stay in Lebanon, fight, or leave. An endless list of questions. And imagine a life where our decisions are not aligned with our values and priorities. We won't be at peace. We won't feel authentic and obviously confused. We've all been there, all of us. During the last month of my first pregnancy, I was living a dilemma. Lost between continuing to build a career or taking a break to give my baby the time he needs to grow, to breastfeed, and feel loved. Having a job gave me a sense of identity, a sense of purpose, something to rely on when I get confused, when I lose direction, and when I ask myself, who am I? Building a career for 8 long years and shifting to a stay-at-home mom was uncertain and scary. I was afraid to lose my position, my financial independence, even my office, obviously my comfort zone. We tend to do things that are visible to us and to people around us because we want to be acknowledged. We want to feel appreciated. Motherhood is most of the times an invisible job that you are rarely rewarded for. Even if you have the best set of skills and a great performance in HR terms. So instead of who am I started to think about what do I value? What do I stand for? And that was the moment, a moment of relief, a moment of authenticity, a moment of alignment with a new priority based on a new value. 10 days later, after the delivery, my husband and I joined our index fingers along with Ghazi's little tiny hand, and we all pressed enter. The three of us just sent my resignation letter. This was my personal story, my personal decision. But no decision is right or wrong. What really matters is that regardless what your decisions are in life, let them be aligned with your priorities. Let them be aligned with what you believe is valuable. And by the way, being able to exercise your values and priorities is success in its own right. But what is success? What is success? What is your definition of success? Not your friends, not your parents, not Hollywood, not Facebook, not Instagram's version of success. Your version of success. Because sometimes we tend to live based on somebody else's definition of what success is. But we've got this uniqueness in us. We've got different characters, different capabilities, different life circumstances, and different life perspectives. So why make it all look the same? For my mother, Zhao San, her most important definition for success is to see her 4 kids well-educated, establishing healthy, loving families, and giving back to society. So as you see, one's definition of success could be entirely different than yours. It's never universal. Take, for example, Samer, a fresh graduate I recently met, who consciously decided not to accept a promising job abroad because there was no one to take care of his mother after his father died. Sausan, Samir, and many more would have never been able to make such decisions unless their values and priorities were clear. Different people, different meanings for success, and all the hidden stories that we never hear of and we never speak of. So it's not always about the money or a job. It's not always materialistic. And it doesn't have to shine. And it doesn't have to be online. We tend to underestimate ourselves and the good things that we do. Tonight, when you go home, take 5 minutes, just 5 minutes, to think of the many moments when you inspired someone, when you gave your time and focused attention to someone, a time when you drove to university from home to explain a chapter or concept to your friend. Maybe a time when you babysat your nephew. You will discover that you have succeeded many, many times so far. And here I am, standing before you to tell you that next time when these cliche quotes smack you in the face, do not get confused. Instead of asking, who are you? Think about, what do you stand for? Clarify your values. Identify your priorities. Align your decisions. And witness your actions leading to true successes. Thank you.